Now that you've been practicing this more, Mavi, can you see it when it starts to entrain?
Brainprint is a technique for identifying people with their brain activity.
And can you just adjust him a little side to side?
We record people's brain activity while they look at a series of images that are designed to elicit very unique responses from person to person. So you might see a picture of a sushi and a picture of a pizza and a picture of Adam Sandler and a picture of Kim Kardashian and the word conundrum and a whole bunch of things rapidly flashing at you.
Take a reading, 25. Where did you put it? Right there.
So when you take hundreds of those, where every person is going to feel differently about each individual one, then you can be really accurate in identifying which person it was that looked at them just from their brain activity.
The key idea of Brainprint is we want to establish a new biometric. The concept of biometric you may be more familiar with, like a fingerprint, iris recognition, face recognition. Those biometrics, they are good, they are very accurate in identifying individuals, but they have several key limitations.
Okay. Look at that.
Okay.
Using EEG or brain activity as a way of biometrics, you know, has been proposed before. But the difference is previously people more focused on active thinking. We are focusing on the more challenging but more unique, non-volitional, intuitive brain response. We want to identify and recognize the individual person based on their inside thinking. Okay, inside brain activity, that is non-visible. That means even the user cannot be aware of that.
My collaboration with Zhanpeng Jin is kind of unique because he's an engineer and I'm a psychologist, and most of the past attempts at brain biometrics have been made just by engineers. And that collaboration has been really fruitful because it crosses cybersecurity and biometrics and cognitive neuroscience and psychology. And I think it's why our Brainprint protocol is more accurate and faster than any of the existing protocols.
You can do that in the brain too.
My graduate student Maria Ruiz Blondet has shown that we can achieve 100% identification accuracy, and that was a huge breakthrough.
This idea is based on the scientific rationale. Okay, everyone is supposed to have the unique memory and knowledge.
We're unique, our brains are unique, our thoughts are unique, our feelings are unique. It's really like quantifiable. You are not the same as any other person. We definitely see the applications of Brainprint as being use for access to very high security locations, like the Pentagon.
So we think the Brainprint will definitely represent the very promising next generation biometrics.
Have a seat, young research assistant.